एवरीवन, वेलकम टू लेक्चर 7 ऑफ प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एंड कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग कोर्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टू इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग। वन इज इनपुट एंड आउटपुट। अनदर थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आफ्टर इनपुट आउटपुट, दैट इज डेटा टाइप, राइट? ऑल्दो यू आर फेमिलियर विद दिस थिंग, बट फॉर्मली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एंड सम न्यू थिंग्स यू आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट इनपुट आउटपुट एंड आवर डेटा टाइप, राइट? So a data stream is a sequence of data, okay? Like you know, we are using IO stream, right? I told you IO stands for input stream or output stream. Where input generally we are giving from keyboard, right? And output we are seeing in the monitor, right? But if you go for programming, right? It is usually you have to use the file to give input, or file to get the output. Why we are using file? Because sometimes, suppose I will tell you 800 numbers, right? So I have to supply the 100 number in a particular file. The file may be a text file or many any file which is readable through the command, right? So yeah, I will give 100 numbers in a particular file. So writing these 100 numbers through keyboard is very difficult, right? So you can insert a particular file. The program is going to take this particular file and perform the addition of 100 numbers, right? So generally we are writing characters or numbers in the input, right? And we are getting characters, numbers in the output, right? So based upon our input, the processing is done, accordingly the output is generated, right? Now you know that we are using cout for the output stream, okay? Like I told you, output stream, the destination is typically your monitor or file. Sometimes we are using printer also to print a particular thing. At that time also you can say printer is my output stream. Destination is our printer, right? All of you please unmute. So C out is an output stream sending data to the monitor, right? So we are using C out generally to display something in the output stream. Let it be a file or let it be a monitor or let it be a printer, right? And the operator what we are using, which I called you earlier as double less than, right? That is called as your insertion operator. Similarly, double greater than is called as extraction operator, right? That we are going to see in C in case, right? Like in the previous class example, we are writing C out number underscore of underscore bars, but it is not written in double quote. So the value of number of bars will be printed, but anything is written within this double quote will be printed, right? Like you have written space candy bars slash n. So space candy bars will be printed and slash n will make you to the next line, right? So remember, if you are not writing in double quote, you are printing the value. But if you are writing the quoted one, then whatever things you are writing, whether you are doing some spelling mistake or typing mistake, the same thing will be printed except this slash n, because slash n is a escape sequence to create a new line, right? Similarly, a new insertion operator is used for each item of the output. For example, you can see there is an insertion operator here, there is another insertion operator here. For number of bars, we have written insertion operator here. For candy bars, we have written an insertion operator here. Like that, you have to display multiple things at the same time also, right? So here you can see I have also written in two different lines. That is also allowed, right? A blank space can also be inserted. Like here I have added a blank space. And instead of writing a single cout statement, like our previous slide, we are using single cout statement. I have written two cout statement. That is also, there is no issue, right? Then you can also write like this, cout total cost in dollar. So output, it will come total cost in dollar, right? Total cost in is dollar, right? Then you are writing price plus text. So price, there should be some value, text some value should be there. For example, price is 5 rupees and text is, let's say, 2 rupees. So it will print as output total cost is $7, right? So this bracket will not be printed, okay? Because this you have not written in double quote. So this is calculated, this will be calculated. The price value will be added with the tax and the value will be written here, right? Similarly, quoted strings are enclosed in the double quotes. Suppose I am writing Walter in the double quote, the same thing will be displayed in the output string. But don't use two single quote. Double quote is not same as two single quote. That is wrong, right? So you have to use here double quote only, not single quote, right? And a blank space can also be inserted by writing C out, your insertion operator, and double quote. Within double quote, you have a blank space, right? So if you write like that, for example, I'll write C out, then I will write, let's say, NIT, right? Then I will write another insertion operator, then I will write a blank double quote, then I will write Warringal, right? So if you write like this, then your output will come as NIT Warringal, right? So that will become a blank space also you can add. So if there are no strings in which a space is desired, for example, in this case, you can see there is a space here, okay? There is a space here. So the same thing will be come in the output, right? But if you put a, if you don't put a space here, it will be merged with the previous word. It will append it to the previous word so that, for example, you have written XYZ prior to that. So if there is no space, it will come like this. So you have to interpret XYZ is different and candy is different. That's why this particular space is also very much important, right? Now you can see that you have to include directives, add libraries to our program. Like you know that C in, C out. I already told you C in, C out are their definitions are available inside this particular arrow file, right? That's why it's saying to make the definition of C in, C out available to the program, you have to write has include. I for input, post and output. And using directives include a collection of defined items to make the names C in, C out available our program. We have to write using namespace STD. I told you whatever name you are using, whether it is C in or C out or any keyword, that has a specific meaning. So you have to define the names in a standard way for which you are writing using namespace STD. Okay, you cannot declare C in, C out as a variable or an identifier. That is wrong, right? The C in, C out has some specific meaning as for the C++ standard, right? So that you have to write. Next, you know that escape sequences are there, like /n is used for new line. Similarly, you can use an alternative. You can write C out and L, right? For example, you can write C out. For example, I am writing a message like NIT, then I am specifying and L, okay, ENDL, and L, then I am writing ENDL, then I am writing a semicolon, right? If you do like this, then in your output, you are going to get NIT, okay, then there is a line break will be there. The next C out will be executed from here. For example, here I have written another C out statement. Like I have written here IIT within double quote, I have written, let's say, IIT. So IIT will come in the next line. Okay. So as alternative of /n, you can use and L. That is also correct, right? Similarly, if you want a space between two different words, you can use /t. If you want to print a backslash character, because you know that anything started with a backslash is an escape sequence, like you can see here. Right, you can see here this is an escape character. So if you want to print a backslash, then you can use double backslash, right? Or if you want to print a quote, right? Right, /quote. So it will print in the output string. Next, if you want to format a real number, sometimes I told you whenever you are declaring a double number and you are printing a double number, right? So output may vary with respect to the compiler, right? So this real number, which data type we are using, the data type we are using in this case is double, produce a variety of output. The output varies with respect to compiler. For example, you can see I have written here double price 78.5. So price is a double variable. So I can write here, this is the price variable. Some memory is allotted to this particular variable. Let's say the memory location for this particular variable is 1000. And the value inside that variable is 78.5, right? So in the output, you are writing, you are to write the price is dollar it will be printed in the screen that the price is dollar, the price is dollar, and after that I want to print the price, right? So what is the price you have declared here? You have initialized it with 78.5. So in the output you have to expect that it will come 78.5, right? But in your output with respect to the compiler, you may get different output. Some case you are getting 78.5, what you have already written here. Some cases you are getting 78.5 and it is followed by 5 zeros. Means it will display up to 6 decimal place, right? Sometimes it is written as 7.85, 4 zeros, okay, that is up to, you can say, up to 6 decimal places. Into e to the power 01, that is 10 to the power 01. E to the power 01 is nothing but 10 to the power 1, right? So you know that 7.85 multiplied by 10 is equal to your 78.5, right? So you can represent the output may come in different format, but if you go for Dev C++, you are going to get the first format, right? But this book stated that most unlikely output is your 78.5. Right, this output will not come, right? Either it is up to whatever you have specified, or it is up to 6 decimal place, or it is 10 to the power 01 format. One of the format it will come, right? So the most unlikely, that you should not expect that 78.5 will come. But if you ask, sir, why if I put here 78.5, what will come? So you can expect that in your output, you are going to get 78.5, right? So this output you should not expect, or 500 you should not expect, 5000 you should not expect. You can expect maximum of 6 decimal places, or in this format. This is called a scientific format we are using. Whenever you go for higher semester, there is a tool you are going to use that is called as MATLAB, right? MAT stands for matrix, L stands for laboratory, right? So matrix laboratory case, generally we are using this particular format, okay? That is 10 to the power format, right? Now, so if you want to show the decimal places, sometimes what happens, you have to decide that how much decimal places you are going to see. For example, your higher authority told, or if you joined a particular company, now your authority says that the output should be in the rupees. So you have to go to two decimal place, like you are saying 78 rupees 50 paisa, right? Nobody is saying 500 paisa, right? So everybody is saying 50 paisa, right? So if you want to go for two decimal plus or three decimal plus, that also you can monitor using this particular command, right? Like here you can see C out include the tools to specify the output of type double. To specify the fixed point, in order to specify the fixed point, you have to write set fixed point your iOS. You have to use double column, that is fixed. I am going to tell you what is the symbol meaning of this particular symbol later. But you have to use iOS double column fixed. Similarly, in order to go for the decimal point, you have to write set F iOS double column so point, right? Like you can see, I have written the same program in the Dev C++ so that it is not confused. So I have written the header file using namespace std main function. I have written C out setup fixed point. For fixed point, I have written this one, which is written here. For your decimal point, I have written the second one, which I have written here. Then I have mentioned C out dot precision is equal to 5. Precision means it will go up to 5 decimal. It will go up to 5 decimal, right? And I have specified now that double price is 78.5, and the price is your price. What is the price? 78.5. But as you have mentioned here, the precision is up to 5 decimal places, it is going to show you 4 zeros it will add, so that it will be go up to 5 decimal places. For example, if you have written here 6 decimal places, then the output should be 78.5 followed by your 5 number of zeros, right? So in this way, you can monitor how much precision you are going to show. For example, if it is the case of paisa, you can specify the precision is 2. So the output will come as 78.50 in this particular case, right? So you can also restrict it, right? That is a important thing what you can see here. Now, We are using the second operator, that is C in for the input stream. We discussed C out for output stream, C in used for your input stream to bringing the data from the keyboard. Through a keyboard you can enter, or through a file also you can supply the data to your program, right? So instead of insertion operator, here we are using the extraction operator. Extraction operator is nothing but your double getter, okay, which removes the data to be used, right? For example, you know that we have already seen this example. C out, enter the number of bars in a particular package, the candy bar program, and I want to display another message that enter weight in ounce of 1 bar, right? Then I am writing C in statement. So one is your number underscore of underscore bars, okay, I am giving input. Another is one underscore weight, I am giving as input, right? So number underscore of underscore bars is you have to supply to keyboard, right? And one underscore weight you have to supply to keyboard. So these two things specify. For example, number of bars you have to specify as 5, weight you have to specify, each weight of each and every bar is 8, right? So you can say the output we are going to get 14, right? So you can see the first value, for first value we are writing 5, right? First value we are writing a scene statement. Second value we are writing a second scene statement, right? And these datas are separated by spaces when entered. For example, you have to enter 5, then you have to enter 8. So it will automatically take first one is number of underscore bars, and second value it is going to take one underscore weight, right? So accordingly it is going to take. So multiple data items are separated by space. As an example, you can see here I am taking multiple things at the same statement. Like previous case you have seen, C in we are using two different statements. One is for number of bars, another is for one weight. You can combine also this thing, right? You can write C in and number of bars, then you have to write one weight followed by your semicolon. It is also correct, right? So here you can see I have declared three variables. One is V1, another is V2, another is V3. Okay, three values we are giving. Then we are asking the user to first we have displayed a message that C out, enter three values. Okay, just a message you have to pass, enter three values, right? Three integer values or something like that. You have to pass a message. So what user will going to do? User is going to supply two values to you, three values to you. One is for V1, another is for V2, another is V3. For example, you can see I have entered 34 space 45 space 12, then I have pressed the enter key, right? So if you see, in this case, V1 is assigned with your 34, V2 is going to be assigned with 45, and V3 is going to assign with 12. In this way, you can also give input to your program in a single statement. Similarly, you can write also by separating, but this is not a good practice. Better to write everything in the same statement, right? If you write like C in V1, C in V2, right? And C in V3, so it is not good, right? So it will increase your space also. Okay, you can combine it and write in a single statement. It is a usual practice. Now you can see here that how you can go for designing input and output. Like I have asked here one statement that enter your age, right? But I have not written a slash in here. So in your computer screen, what will come? It will come enter your age, right? For example, you have written enter. Okay, just a minute. Okay. So you can see in your screen, it will display a message that is enter your age, right? Enter your age, then there is a semicolon, then it is asking C in age. So your cursor is present here because you have not written slash n here. If you write slash n, your cursor is present here. But age you have not written the slash n, so your cursor is here. So here you can enter the value, let's say 30 or 40, something like that, and press enter, right? So you can see there is an absence of new line in this particular program before using C in. So the cursor is present here. So echo the input. So once you are giving input, in order to cross verify whether you have written the correct one or not, you have to echo the input, right? Echo the input means you have to again display whatever value you have entered, the same value you have to display. Like here I have displayed C out age. Age is nothing but whatever you have entered, that is 30, 30, then there is a message will be printed, 30 was entered. So you have cross-checked whatever input you have given input, that the same thing is coming or not, right? That we are saying for the input, right? Okay. Now, at the end of this input and output, you can answer these particular questions. First question says that write an input statement to place a value in the variable the underscore number. You have to place a value to this particular variable. You know how to declare a variable, and you know how you are going to assign a value to a particular variable. Similarly, write the output statement. Here you are writing the input statement. Here you are writing output statement. Okay. You are going to use C in second case, you are going to use C out, right? Output statement to prompt for the value to store the underscore number, right? Similarly, write an output stream, output statement that produces a new write. You know that what you have to write and what is the alternative. Instead of slash n also, you are going to use and n, right? Then format output of rational number to 4 decimal places. I told you there is a precision, right? There is a C out dot precision. You are going to specify the number of digits you are going to show after the decimal point, right? So if it is 5, it will go to 5 decimal. Similarly, you have to write 4 for 4 decimal places, right? Now, the second point of discussion for today's class is nothing but our, you can say, that is data type and expression. Although you are familiar with some of the data types, but we are going to see what is the range. Okay, that we are going to see here. Data types and expression. So 2 and 2.0 is both are same. We are normally in our case, in the real life case, if somebody is saying this cost of this particular thing is 2 rupees, then you can say yes, it is 2.0 rupees. Both are same. But in programmatically, 2 and 2.0 is not the same number, right? You can say 2 is a whole number, but 2.0 is a real number. For whole number case, we are using a data type that is int, but real number case, we are using a data type that is double, right? And number of types int are stored as exact values, right? Number of type int are stored as an exact value, but number of type that is double may be stored as an approximate value due to limitation on number of significant digits that can. For example, if it will ask you what is 10 divided by 3, so you will say, sir, it is 3.333333 like this, right? How many 3s if I ask? You will say, no, sir, it will continue up to a long time, right? So imagine if I want to store in a 5 places, I have 5 places to store these numbers, right? So you will say, sir, first I will store 3, then there's a decimal point, then 333. Your friend is having another memory which is capable to store, let's say, 7 locations, right? So he is storing 3, 3, okay, 3, that is 5 decimals, and extra 2, 3 space can store. Like that, another person is having 10 spaces, he will store more. Somebody is having 100 spaces, it will more, right? So this number is not same as this number, right? Obviously, this number is bigger. But yet you have a limited amount of memory, you are representing 3.333. But if you have unlimited space, this process will continue, right? Up to a big number. You cannot round off it, right? You cannot say 3.333 is 3.34, right? That is, you cannot round, right? That's why it is saying the limitation on the number of significant that can be represented, right? So, that case, you can say double and float is different, because float is capable to store a limited space, double is more than the float. So, float can store a limited 3s after decimal point, the 3s number of 3s, it can store up to a limit, and double can store more than that, right? That's why if I ask a number 3.3333, okay, is it a, if you represent in float or you represent in double, both are same or not, you say no, right? Because the number of bits occupied for float is less than the double, right? Okay, so double is, right? So in this way, you can differentiate. Now, INT is nothing but, INT does not contain the decimal point. It may be 34, it may be 45, it may be 1, or it may be 89, or it may be anything, right? But there should not be any decimal point, and there should not be any value after the decimal point, right? And next one is you can write in double constants, right? For example, you can see here I have declared many things, like I have specified the type as double, can be written in two different ways. If you want to specify a double number, you can specify in two different ways. First one must include a decimal point. For example, here you can say it is 34.1, or it may be 23.0034, or it may be 1.0, it may be 89.9. So these decimal points you can calculate, you can monitor through this cout.precision, right? If you write cout.precision followed by, if you write the precision is 5 or 6 accordingly, in the first case it may be 1, second case it may be 4, third case it is 1, and fourth case it is 1. Like that you can maintain. Another way of representation is that in order to write 34.1, we can write it is nothing but 3.41 into 10 to the power 1. That is called as our scientific notation, or we call as a floating point notation, right? So E indicates 10 to the power 1. Remember, this E indicates 10 to the power 1. This is not 2.718, which you can find in your scientific calculator. If you put E and click press enter, then it is coming 2.718, right? Similarly, if I write 3.67E17, what is the meaning? E indicates 10, 10 to the power 17. So 36, you can say 3.67 and followed by 10 number of 10, 1 followed by 10 zeros. Sorry, 17 zeros. Okay, 10 to the power 17 means what? 10 to the power 17 means 1 followed by 17 number of zeros multiplied by 3.67. Like we are writing 10 to the power 2 is nothing but 1 followed by 2 zeros, right? Or you can write in this format also, like 5.89 e to the power minus 6. Minus 6 is nothing but 10 to the power minus 6 multiplied by 5.89. So here you can see after 5 decimal places, the 5.89 is going to come, right? So number left of e does not require a decimal point. An exponent cannot contain a decimal point. You cannot write 5.89 into e to the power minus 6.5. This, right? This is not allowed, right? Now, other number types, like various number types have different memory requirements. More precision requires more bytes, and very large number requires more bytes. Like I told you, float is having limited one, but double is having more thing, right? So accordingly, you can say float is different from the double, right? Float is capable to only 4 bytes, but double is going to take more, 8 bytes. So obviously, if there is more precision, require more bytes in the memory. If a very large number require more bytes in the memory, right? So accordingly, you have to decide whether to use float or double in the program. So this is the range of various data type. First data type is called as sort, right? Or also we called as sort int, sort space int. Don't write in capital letter, you write in the small letter. Its size is 2 byte, right? 2 byte means what? I told you 1 byte is equal to your how much bit? It is 8 bit, right? Similarly, if you go for 2 bytes is nothing but your 16 bits, right? 2 bytes is nothing but 16 bits. So how to get this range? This range is nothing but minus 3 to 767 to 367, but many books also suggested it is 3 to 768, not 767. But this book, I do not know why they have written 32767, but 32768 to 3277, right? So how you are going to get this value? You open your calculator. No need to remember these values. You go to your computer, open your calculator. I told you 2 bytes is 16 bit, right? 16 bit. So you write 2 and 2 to the power 16, right? You are going to get 65536. You divide it by 2. Whatever value is coming, that is your negative cycle value. That is minus 3 to 768. And you make 1 less, that is your positive cycle value, right? What you have to do? You have to write 2 to the power 16 divided by 2. Then the negative cycle value will come, that is minus 3 to 768, not 767. Okay, minus 3 to 768, and the positive cycle value is 1 less than whatever value it is coming. Similarly, in the int case, it is 4 byte. Generally, it is 4 byte. So 4 byte means, you know, that is 32 bit, right? That is 4 into 8, you are going to get 32, right? So 32 means how you are going to get the range? You have to write 2 to the power 32. Okay, you are going to get a very big number. You divide by 2, you are going to get 21474836 48. Not 7, it is 48. That is the negative cycle. You give minus 1, that is a positive cycle, right? So in this way you can calculate the range. No need to remember this range, you can use a calculator to specify the range. Similarly, long or long int is 4 byte, that is 32 bit. The range is this one. Float is your 4 byte. Okay, the range is 10 to the power minus 30 to 10 to the power 38. Double is 8 byte. It is 10 to the power minus 308 to 10 to the power 308. See this one, the difference between a double number and a float number. That's why we are writing double. Okay, sometimes we require big number to store, that's why we are going for double. Similarly, instead of using int, we are also using long int, right? Although the range is same, okay, in this case it is 4 byte, but I'll tell you in which case int is also 2 byte. I'll tell you later. Okay, but you can see the short int, long int, the difference is, if you calculate, short int case it is 2 byte, but long int case it is 4 byte. Okay, first one is 2 byte, next one is 4 byte, right? Similarly, you go for long double. Sometimes we require very big number, so we are going for 10 to the power minus 4932 to 10 to the power 4932. Okay, so if you calculate the precision, it is very important to note here, the precision is 7 digit. If you are want to do calculation with a 7 digit number and you expect that the output is also a 7 digit number, then you can go for two. But if you assume that it is a 15 digit number, go for a double. If it is a 19 digit number, then you go for long double. Accordingly, you can decide which one is suitable for your right now. But any important question, it is an interview question also. If anybody will ask what is the size of integer, don't tell 4 byte. Or if anybody will ask what is the size of short, don't tell 2 byte. Or if anybody will ask what is the size of float, don't tell 4 byte. What is the size of double? Don't tell 8 byte. So what you are going to tell? You are going to tell the size of integer is nothing but there is a size of operator, size of int. Okay. If you write size of int in a particular program, it is going to tell you what is the size of an integer. You tell the usually it is 4 byte, but if I'll write size of int, then only I am able to know what is the size of integer. Because many compiler, they are taking integer as 2 bytes, right? And many compilers are there, they are also taking 4 bytes, right? That's why in order to avoid this confusion, you can say I can use the size of, within bracket I'll specify int, then it will return me whether it is a 2 byte space or it is a 4 byte space. Similarly, you can also find the size of float, size of double, size of long double, size of short, and size of long also, right? Accordingly, you can check in the next lab class or in your as a homework, you can try this thing and check whether this problem is in your compiler, right? So you can see here the long or long int, or you can see short or short int, you can call them, right? But if you go for long or long int, it is 4 byte. So 4 byte is a very large integer, but short integer is your 2 byte, right? So it is a smaller integer. If you require a integer like 10, 20, 30, 40, then you go for short int. But if you require 1 lakh, 2 lakh type number, you go for long int, right? Here the declaration is like this. You can write long followed by your variable name. You know a variable name is always starting with an alphabet or a underscore followed by alphabet, number or underscore, right? So long, big underscore, their total. Here you can see long, long int is your data type and you are writing big underscore total. Similarly, you can see in the case of a smaller integer case, there is a, you can write short small total, small underscore total, or you can write short int small underscore total. In this way, you can declare a long or long int or short int. Similarly, long double is a very big number, right? As I specified, it is 10 bytes, okay? So it declares a floating point number with up to 19 significant digits. If you are writing a program where 19 significant digit, that much big number is required, then you can go for long double. That is, long double is the data type and your variable name is big underscore number. Similarly, if you go for float, float is nothing but it is up to 7 significant digit. So float is your data type. Underscore flow underscore big underscore number is nothing but your variable, right? So like that you can declare the values. Okay, the very simple data type is character. We generally take 1 byte. So computer process character data to, right? Character is sort for character, like nothing but A is a character, B is a character, C is a character. It may be capital A, it may be small a, right? But it's a case sensitive language. So capital A has different meaning than the small, right? And you can see can be any single character from the keyboard. Whenever somebody is asking about to enter a character, you can enter any character. Okay. If you are writing also special symbol also, that is also treated as a character, right? To declare a character, you have a data type char, right? And the variable name is letter, right? So in this way, you can declare a particular variable, right? But if you want to assign a particular value to that particular character, you have to write in a single quote, right? Like I have declared character, I have declared that is character letter in the previous slide. I can also write letter is equal to in the single quote it is A, okay? Or you can combinely write character letter is equal to A. So this is called as your character constant. Generally, character constants are enclosed by single quote, not double quote, single quote. Okay, and you know that float is 4 byte, right? You can also go for a group of character. We call the group of character as string. Okay, string is nothing but a group of character. Like I will say N is a character, I is a character, T is a character, but together NIT is a string, right? String is nothing but a group of character, right? So even if only one character is enclosed in the double, also called as a string. That means writing A like this and writing A like this is different, right? Writing A like this is your character, but writing A in double quote, it is called as our string. So both are different. If you are saying character is taking 1 byte, in this case you are going to take 1 byte, but in the second case we are going to reserve 2 byte, right? Because one is for the character, another is for the backslash zero, which is called a null character. Backslash zero is called a null character. Every string is going to end by the null character, right? Okay, that is backslash zero, right? So writing A in a single quote and a double quote is different, right? Like you can see, A is a value of type character, but A in double quote is a string of character containing one character. Right, one character is there, but if you go for memory representation, one location A is there, another location for null character. And null character indicates that is the end of the string. Next, if you go for C++ 11 types, the size of memory data types can vary from one machine to another machine. Just I told you, if somebody is asking what is the size of integer, you simply tell size of operator within bracket int. Will tell me whether it is a 32-bit system or a 32-bit occupation or a 64-bit memory occupation, right? So 32 bits means your 4 bytes, 64 bits means it is 8 bytes. So it varies with respect to one compiler to another compiler. And C++ 11 introduced a new integer type, okay, that specifies exactly the size, whether or not the data type is signed or unsigned. Signed means if you are going for a positive number or a negative number. Unsigned means by default it is a positive number. Such type of data types are also available. Sometimes what we are using, we are using an auto type, okay? Without specifying a particular data type name, we are specifying auto. So this deduces the type of variable based upon the expression on the right hand side of the assignment. For example, you can see here in the right hand side, I want to calculate 2.4 multiplied by 10. You know 2.4 is a double number, right? And 10 is nothing but an integer number, right? It is a double number and it is an integer number. So when you multiply a double number with integer number, it will be stored in Excel. But its data type is your auto. So if you calculate this one, how much you are going to get? You are going to get 24, right? So 24. Maybe it is an integer or it may be a double, right? For example, in this case, you can say it is 24.0, right? So x becomes your double due to this 2.4. right? So if you write some data type as auto, it depends upon what you are evaluating in that expression. If you are evaluating and the resultant is your double number, so x is a double number. But when you multiply 2 with 4, 2 is an integer, 4 is an integer, so their multiplication is 8 is stored in the f, and x is also a integer, right? So it varies with respect to the type of calculation or type of expression you are writing in the right hand side. You can see a couple of type name, like you can write int 8 underscore t, which is 1 byte, int, that is unsigned int 8 underscore c, int 16 underscore t, unsigned int 16 underscore t, int 32 underscore t, unsigned int 32 underscore c. So based upon that, 32 bit or 16 bit or 8 bit is returned in the number, right? So these, the range are also you can calculate in the calculator. But whenever you are going for unsigned, you know, this is 8 bit, right? 8 bit means 2 to the power 8. In calculator, you will write 2 to the power 8. Calculator, if you are writing 2 to the power 8, how much you are going to get? You are going to get 256. That's why the range is 8 to 255, right? So no need to divide, right? Because it is the unsigned one, right? So it is a unsigned one, right? So the range, whatever you are going to get in this one byte is nothing but 0 to 2. But it is maybe unsigned one or a signed one. So 2 to the power 8, here it is 256, but we are going to divide by 2. If you are going to divide it by 2, you are going to get 128. That is nothing but your negative part. And if you guess 1, you are going to get your positive cycle part. That is 127. So in this way, you can decide what is the range of the particular data type. Now C in speech blank and line, right? So whenever you are going for C programming, if you are putting unnecessary blanks, blank spaces or line breaks, so it is ignoring that part, okay? Looking for the data. The following reads the two character but skips any space that might be, right? For example, I have written character symbol 1, comma, symbol 2, right? I have declared two variables, one is symbol 1 and another is symbol 2. So as an input, I am asking symbol 1 or symbol 2, right? So if they are putting some extra spaces here also, that will be ignored. So usually as you have defined a character, so I told you, symbol 1 can store only one character. That is nothing but a single code. You can store one character. Similarly, in the symbol 2, you can store a single character, right? Like symbol 1 case, I am giving input as J. And in symbol 2 case, I am giving input as D. So if a user now the data type item by putting the space in the output, when it will ask enter two character, generally our tendency is that we are writing J space D. So J is assigned to your symbol 1 and D is assigned to your symbol 2. In this way, the assignment is done, right? And results are the same if the data is not separated by space. Even if the result you are writing input as JD and symbol 1 can store only one character, it will capture the first one and symbol 2 is going to capture the second. But usual practice is you have to follow this one. You have to put the space in between two characters. So here is an example what we discussed. Here I am asking enter two initials without any period. So you are writing J space V. So as an output, I am showing the two initials are symbol 1, symbol 2. Symbol 1 is your J, okay? Symbol 2 is your G. So your output, B. So your output, you are getting J V, right? Because you have not given any space between the symbol 1 and symbol 2. So in this case, I am writing once more with a space. So it is printing once more this space, then backslash n, it will go to the next line. Symbol 3 is equal to, there is a blank character. Then I am displaying symbol 1, symbol 3, then symbol 2. Symbol 1 is your J, okay? Then there is a space, then symbol 2 is your D, right? And I am printing that's all. So this is the output you are going to get if you are writing a particular program. So you have to be careful whenever you are displaying a character or whenever you are taking input as a character, right? Only in the character case you must have program. Now string is a class different from the primitive data type discussed so far. In this case, you can see that we are giving two input, right? One is symbol 1 and symbol 2. User is writing A space B. So if you are writing space, it is ignored. So J is stored in symbol 1, B is stored in the symbol 2, right? Then the message you are printing, the two initials are symbol 1, symbol 2. So whenever you are displaying J, B, Okay, symbol one is J and symbol two is B. So in your output, you are going to get JB without space because you have not written any space here. But while you are entering, you have put any one space that is ignored by the compiler. So if you want to introduce the space in between JB, so you have to declare another symbol three and there is a blank character. What I will do, symbol one is your J, symbol three is your blank character, symbol two is nothing but B. So here in the output, you are going to get J space B. And that's all, right? So string is a class different from the primitive data type discussed so far. So string is a separate data type, a group of character we are declaring to say that it is a string, right? So we are going to discuss this thing later because there is an explicit chapter on the string where we are going to practice so many things about the string. So generally we are representing string in the double quote, right? So require the following to be added to the top of the line. You have to add has include string, right? If it is missing, you have to write has include. Like you are writing IOStream, you have to write string if you want to deal with the string operation. Because plenty of operations are available under this string header file, right? That's why you need to write the header file, right? Yes, it is coming now. It has include string. So this you have to add in addition to your has include IOStream. For example, I want to write string name is equal to some name I am writing. So I can write string and name is a variable which is capable to store a big two words with a big name you can store, right, in the string. But character case you can store only one character, either it is A or B or Z or X or Y, whatever may be, you can store only one character. So in this program, if you see what I am doing, I have declared three things. One is our middle name, another is our pet name, another is alter ego name, right? So you can see I am displaying a message that is enter your middle name and the name of your pet, right? In the output, you can see this message can be printed. A slash n is there, we will go to the next line. In the next line, you are entering two words. One is Parker, another is Pippen, right? So Parker is nothing but your middle and pet name is Pippen. Then I am writing alter underscore ego underscore name is pet name plus there is a blank character in order to separate these words. Okay, and the middle name is nothing but your Parker, right? Pippen, blank character, and your middle name is your Parker, right? So this you have stored under the alter underscore ego underscore name. So when you print this statement in the output, it will come the name of your alter ego is, as you are not writing slash n, and in the next line you are going to write alter ego name. So it is going to print Pippen, pet name, you know, by pet name you are specified as Pippen. Okay, then there is a space, then there is a Parker is your middle name, which is stored in the alter underscore ego underscore name, right? And followed by a full stop, right? And you have written end l, so cursor will go to here and to end the execution. Similarly, if you want to print take as a input as Parker, right? For example, in this case, I am taking Parker as a input, which is nothing but your middle name. You can see this is your middle name. The second one you are writing Mr. and Mr. dot a person's name. Okay, so as you are entering three words, here you are entering three words, so it is taking Parker as your middle name, pet name as Mr. So when you display the alter underscore ego name, what will be displayed? The first one is your pet name. The pet name is nothing but Mr. and it is going to put a space here. Then middle name is nothing but your Parker. So it is going to print Mr. Parker and it is ignoring this particular word, right? As you are entering, it is require only two words, but you are entering three words, so that is ignored. Now, in general, store values in the variables of the same type. This is a type mismatch. Sometimes what happens? You can see here, I have declared an int underscore variable. This variable is an integer type, but I am storing a floating point number, right? So integer can store only 2, right? It cannot store 2.99. So in this case, what happened? If your compiler allow this, int underscore variable will most likely contain 2. It is going to store 2 and it is going to ignore this decimal point. It is not going to round up it to 3, right? It is simply ignoring whatever there after the decimal point. So that is called as your type compatibility. So you have to ensure that if you have declared INT, you are supplying only 2. Even if you are supplying 2.99, it is not going to print in 2.99 in the output. So now you are going to see that conversation between INT and double. So here you can see INT variable. So INT variable is of integer type. Double underscore variable is a double type. Then I am assigning double underscore variable is 2.0. I am initializing that variable. 2.00 is assigned to double underscore variable. Then what happened? I am assigning a double variable to an integer variable. Double variable to integer variable. So this integer variable contain only integer value, right? Not a decimal point. So it is going to take only 2, not 2.00. So that is the conversion between the INT and double or double and INT, right? Similarly, if you see here, I am writing double variable. I am writing double underscore variable is 2, right? But 2 is an integer. 2 is an integer, but double underscore variable is what? Your double number. So it is going to take 2.0. In order to say that, here what you are doing, an integer is converted to double. In the previous case, a number is converted to the integer. Similarly, you can do the conversions between the character and INT. So I have written here INT value is equal to A. See here, A is a character constant, right? This is your character constant. Okay, but this is possible. You are assigning a character to an integer. What you are doing? A is a character, right? Usually you are writing 2 or 3, that is okay. But here we are writing a character constant and you are assigning to an integer, right? It is possible because of the type conversion, but it should not be recommended, right? You should not use such type of statement. If you are going to do also, what it is going to store? It is going to store the integer representing A. Like capital A is represented by 65, so it is going to store the value as 65. So it is possible to store INT values in character variables, right? So you can see here, instead of this character, if you write character value is equal to A, then that is fine, right? Because value is a character, right? It can capable to store a character, so that is possible. But in this case, what we are doing, we are assigning to an integer. So the corresponding value of A, if you see the ASCII code, I told you in earlier classes, there are two code, one is ASCII and ABCDIC code, the value is 65. So the integer containing A, that is 65, is going to store in the variable value, which is integer type, right? Similarly, you can also do conversation between bool and INT. Right, it is also possible, but it is not recommended. Bool means boolean value. Boolean value means just like our binary logic, whether it is 0 or 1, where 1 indicates true and 0 indicates false. Right, so values of type bool can be assigned to INT variables. True means 1 and false means 0. So in this case, you know that values of the type INT can be assigned to bool. You can do conversation between INT to bool and bool to INT. There is no problem because 1, 0, these values are nothing but your integer values, right? Integer is going to store 1 or 0. That is possible because its range is -32768 to 32767. So all values are coming in that range. So you can do. So any non-zero integer is stored is true. So if you are doing such conversation, integer can store a very long range, but bool can store only two things, either 1 or 0. So any non-zero value you are entering, that is treated as true. But whenever you are writing a zero value, that is treated as false. In this way, the bool can be mapped with the integer, right? Now you can apply a couple of arithmetic operations. Like, you know, in your calculator, addition operation is there, subtraction operation is there, multiplication and division operation is there. All the operations you can apply to in our program, right? Like we already seen in the candy bar example, we are multiplying one weight with the number of bars, right? With a multiplication symbol. When you multiply these two things, we are going to get total underscore weight. Total weight underscore weight is a variable. One underscore weight is a variable. Number of underscore bar is also a variable. So which we called as operand. This is your operand, and you can say this is a operand. This is operand, this is another operand, this is another operand. And we call this one as a operator. This is also an operator, right? So in between two operand, you must have a operator. Like here you have used multiplication operator in between one weight and number of bars. And once this multiplication is done, you are assigning that to total weight. So equal to is also an operator that we call as the assignment operator. So arithmetic operators can be used with any numeric type, and an operand is a number of used by the operator. Right? We are using two operands. In between that, we are writing an operator. And the result of an operator depends upon the type of operand. If both operand is empty, like I am writing first value is 2 and second value is also 2, so the result is also integer. This is an integer. This is another integer. 2 is a operand. And this 2 is also an operand, and this is your operator. You are going to get output as 4, right? So that is also an integer. If one of the operand is double, for example, I am multiplying 2 with 0.0, so both are not same. 2 is an integer, 2.0 is a double. So if you multiply that, in the output you are going to get 4.0. So if one of the operand is double, then the output you are going to get, that is also double. Similarly, you can see there is a good example here. I have taken two things. One is divisor, another is dividend. But all things I have declared in the double. So divisor is a integer number. Dividend is a integer number. So when you divide, this dividend is 5 and divisor is 3, you are going to get 1.666. So the quotient is going to store 1.666, right? But whatever input you are giving, that is an integer, right? So integer means it is going to be converted. When you assign it to a divisor, it is an integer is going to convert it to a double. So this value is stored as 3.0. 5 is assigned to the dividend, so it is stored as 5.0. So whenever you are doing the multiplication, it is not 5 plus 3, it is nothing but 5.0 divided by 3.0. So we are going to get 1.666. It will continue and it is going to store in the quotient. Okay, be careful with the division operator. Sometimes if you are doing with int, int, it is going to produce an integer number. True for variables or numeric constants, right? If you specify, generally divide 3, 5 divided by 3, as it is a conversion is there in between the int to double, so it will come. The output is 1.66, it will come. Okay, so but in the maximum cases, sometimes what happens, 5 is an integer and 3 is an integer, the result is also an integer. But in this case, everything you have written in the double, so we are going to get 1.666, right? So you can see here, I have declared all the values is now in the integer, right? In this case, I have declared an integer, dependent is integer, divisor is integer. So dependent divided by divisor. How much you are going to get? 1.666. But this quotient is declared as an integer. This quotient is declared an integer, we are going to store 1 into the quotient, right? But in the previous case, what happened? You have declared instead of int, you have declared double. So as you have declared double, and 5 is considered as 5.0, divisor is considered 3.0. So we are doing 5.0 divided by 3.0. We are going to get 1.666, right? In this way, you can do it. The value of the quotient is 1 in this case, but not 1.666. So integer division does not round the result. So you should not expect 1.666 means it is 2, right? In our childhood also, whatever calculation we are doing, we are saying 1.666, it is above 0.5, so it is 2. So it will not be rounded. But fractional part, whatever fractional part is coming, whether it is 999 or 001, that will be discarded. Similarly, you can use the modulus operator, right? You know, whenever you are writing modulus operator, so your dividend is 5, divisor is 3. So it is nothing but 5 modulus of 3. Okay, 5 modulus of 3 is nothing but if you divide 5 by 3, how much you are going to get? 3, 1 is 3, right? Then you are getting the remainder is 2. So that remainder is called as your modulus of 3. Okay, so suppose I will write 6 modulus of 3 is equal to 0. Because 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. So your resultant is 0, right? Now, a couple of arithmetic expressions are there. You can convert to C++. For example, somebody asked me about the quadratic equation. You are writing b square minus 4ac. So there is no square operation, right, in our C++. What you are writing? B into b minus 4 into a into c. You can also use power operator, but I have not defined till now. So I'm skipping that thing. So you can write B into B minus 4 into A into C. So in order to avoid confusion, you can put a bracket like this also. Similarly, X into Y plus Z. So you have to write Y plus Z first, it will evaluate. Whatever the addition is coming, it is going to multiply with X. Similarly, 1 divided by X square, that is X plus X plus X plus 3. That can be also done. Or A plus B divided by C minus D. A plus B, okay, divided by C plus D. So first A plus B will be calculated, then C minus D will be calculated, then the division is going to be done, right? In this way, you can write the expressions. Some of the expressions occur so often that the C++ contains to shortened of sort and operator. There is some shortened operators are there. For example, we are writing count is equal to count plus 2, right? You are using the same variable in the LHS side as well as in the right hand side. So what you can write? Count plus or equal to 2. So this plus equal to is nothing but your shorthand operator. So which meaning that count is equal to count plus 2. Similarly, bonus is equal to bonus into 2. Right? In this case also you can write bonus star equal to 2. Both are same. So if you write shorthand operator, that is better. Time is equal to time slash ROS underscore factor. So it can be written as time slash equal to ROS factor, where slash equal to is nothing but your shorthand operator. Remainder is equal to remainder modulus CNT1 plus CNT2. So with that also you can write a shorthand operator, that is modulus equal to, and you can assign to the remainder, right? So in this way you can use the operator and operand, data types and input.